Good evening, it's Long Haul Tanker, Straight Razor Shaving with Long Haul Tanker, and it is Wednesday, the 22nd of March, 2023, at 1755, approximately Mountain Time, and I am at the Love's Truck Stop at Sidney, Nebraska, and I've got a 48 hours worth of growth on my face of whiskers, and we're going to do a straight razor shave. If you're joining me on YouTube, I say thank you, welcome. Hit the like and subscribe button and leave a comment if you so wish. Be polite and respectful, and I'll do the same in return. Go on over to the Shaving Cadre, www.theshavingcadre.com. Join in the conversation. You'll enjoy the website, all about wet shaving, straight razor shaving, and other things. There are a number of fellows over there that do shaving related video content. I mention their names quite frequently. I'm just going to put them in the description this evening. And let's get started on the shave. The equipment I'm going to use tonight, my razor, is a Thiers Assard 5/8 shoulderless. It's got the imprint on the blade of the Art of Shaving. It's got real nice wood, box elder or something, I don't remember right now, and it's nicely engraved, laser etching, I'm sure. And you know, if you watch me very long, you see when I get home, I use that brush with the nickel handle that my wife got me in Las Vegas. Well, this is the razor. I won't call it a set because they were bought separately, but this is the razor she bought me for me at the same time she bought that brush, and it's just a real nice combination. I love this razor, as I do with all my gear. All right, the brush for this evening is QED Select Silvertip Manturian Badger 28 millimeter set in faux horn. And just a lovely brush. Couldn't ask for a better brush at three times the price. My soap for this evening is Sterling Gentleman. I have it soaking in some water. Let's see what it's going to give me right now. Had a nice hot shower. The bowl is only tepid hot. It's not. In fact, let's run that a little bit and see if we can get it hotter. Last shave video I had, you saw me at the driver's lounge restroom. Where I did a shave before leaving out. That trailer was 5 to 6 hours late getting back to the yard, and I wasn't going to take it out Monday night. And so I left yesterday. I spent the night last night in Guthrie, Oklahoma, North Oklahoma City. What normally takes me an 8.5 hours to get there to Guthrie from the yard ended up taking me almost a full 11 hours because there were one accident in Houston trying to get out of town, and then there was two accidents in Dallas, and I ended up taking a detour jumping off. And if you know anything about Dallas freeways, 635 on the north side, jumped off to the west, got on the George Bush turnpike, and took it north till it rejoined Interstate 35. And then I jumped in the express lane and took it all the way to Denton, because I wasn't going to risk any more delays and slowdown. By the time I hit the Oklahoma state line, it was clear sailing and not hardly any slowdown in Oklahoma City. I've already had one knock on the door, even before I got in the shower. Are you done yet? And if you watch me for very long, you know how much I just despise that. It does not have the kind of locks on the door that say vacant or occupied. It's not a deadbolt. It's an electronic lock. I'm going to go with that to get started tonight. So I left out from Guthrie, Oklahoma this morning at approximately 6 o'clock and got here at approximately, it was 4:30 mountain time, so I gained an hour in my favor. And I'm headed to Calgary, Alberta. Cross over on Sunday afternoon. Sunday morning, hit the truck stop. About one or two o'clock. 1300, 1400 in Calgary, my preferred truck stop. All right, let's get this show on the road. Honed up on the Shapton Glass progression, 1K, 2K, 4K, 8K, and then to the 30K, finished on the 30K. So far, so good. The first strokes are very crisp and popping. I don't know if you can hear the Sterling soap is got lots of good slickness there. My fingers are slipping up on top. So today was the 600, approximately a 650 mile day. And I'm about 2 hours from Cheyenne. I knew it was snowing in Cheyenne from the weather reports. And I figured it'd probably start snowing sooner or later. And as I was about 20 minutes out from Sydney, Nebraska, I started getting light snow showers, light flurries. Remained so, but the one thing that changed that was ominous was the squall line coming in from the west was just dark and long and massive, and so I suspect it's going to snow tonight here. Wouldn't be surprised. But tomorrow's supposed to be fine. No snow in the forecast. But I'll double check later. It's still warm temperatures, anywhere from the mid-40s to the mid-30s, all the way up to Calgary, Casper, even Cheyenne has got moderate temperatures. Freezing at night, but mid-30s and 40s during the daylight hours. Here comes the knocking. see all those whiskers getting whisked away? Just a beautiful thing, and it feels terrific. Got plenty of soap, probably more than I'll need for both the face shave and the head shave. I'm approximately 13, 14 hours away from the Les Truck Stop in Great Falls, Montana. And I'll plan on getting there on Friday sometime, mid to late afternoon, and lay over there Friday afternoon, all day Saturday, and depart out Sunday from 5.5 hours to Calgary. So it was a good day of driving, 650 miles, that's a long day. I think I ended up leaving about 30 to 45 minutes on my drive clock. Of course, this is a major hub area, Cheyenne and this location. Coming out of the west, headed east and vice versa. This soap is interesting. It smells quite aromatic, like an aftershave, but I get the hint. I haven't read the ingredients, so I can't speak specifically, but it's like there's a hint of tobacco. So I'm enjoying the enjoying the scent off of the soap. Oh, very nice. So for the next couple of days, I'm in no particular hurry. My intended goal for tomorrow night is Hardin, which is about 8 hours. Hardin, Montana. And between where I'm at right now, there's only two more remaining Love's truck stops. One in Cheyenne and one in Hardin, which is Hardin, Montana, which is nearly 6 hours away. And I think that's a bit long. I think there ought to be another one either in Casper, Wyoming, which is about 2 hours, 2.5 hours north of Cheyenne, or in Sheridan. Casper or Sheridan. Well, Casper is 2.5 hours up, so there are other truck stops there, but not a Love's. And so Sheridan would be about another hour or so north of Casper, and that would be a great place for a Love's truck stop, because I'd make it 2 hours then on to Hardin. And it's kind of the midway point between, Cheyenne and Hardin. And Hardin's about 40 miles to the southeast on, it's either Interstate, I think it's Interstate 94. Before you get to Billings. So it's just right outside of Billings. Just fine. feel just, yep. Got water on my fingers, I'm slipping a little bit. And I know some people would use alum, but I'm not going to. I don't want to even risk getting alum on my carbon steel. I can feel those whiskers just popping in the feedback on the blade. Very nice. All right. Almost done. Little palm stropping there. Yes, very good. All right, let's rinse it down and see what we got. Then we'll give it the finishing strokes if we think we need them. Or we'll just do them for fun. That's about perfect. So we have our Thiers Assard, the art of shaving, with nice etched scales. We're going to set that aside now and get onto the head shave. And we're using the Union razor, nothing special about it. Plenty of soap, don't I? Now we won't load it up quite as heavy on the neck shave. I can say this soap is very slick. I don't know if it's any more or less than others of Sterling soaps, but it is giving me the impression tonight that it is very slick. Okay, that's it for the head shape. Let's do the back of the neck and be done with this thing. I hear the beast gathering at the door. There we go. All right, we're done. We used the Thiers-Assard Art of Shaving with the etched scales for the face shave. We used the Union razor for the head shave. And the brush art tonight was QED Select Manchurian Silvertip Badger, and our soap was the Sterling Gentleman, which is a delightful smell. A little on the dark side, but that's not a bad thing, is it? Dark, a little tobacco-y, in my opinion. You know what? Next time I use it, probably in Great Falls on Saturday, I will give a description of the elements in the soap, but it's a delightful. I'll be using it all week. Okay, that's it. I'm done. Go over to the Shaving Cadre and have a great evening. This is Long Haul Tanker, and I will see you down the road.